this brother here, myself, all of us were born with our hair like this, and we just wear it like this because it's natural, because the reason for it, you might say, is like a new awareness among black people that their own natural appearance, physical appearance, is beautiful and it's pleasing to them. For so many, many years, we were told that only white people were beautiful. Only straight hair, light eyes, light skin was beautiful. And so black women would try everything they could, straighten their hair, lighten their skin, to look as much like white women. And the black men would let it be known that they thought white women were beautiful, and they'd say they didn't want any ugly black woman with short hair, this whole thing. But this has changed because black people are aware, and white people are aware of it too, because white people now want natural wigs. They want wigs like this. Dig it? Isn't it beautiful? All right.
Man, the Panthers, they seem crazy. They seem like they're ready to go to war. I'm going to join the Black Panther Party. So I got a few of my boys together, and we rode out to Brooklyn. And I'm telling them on the way in, I'm going to do whatever it takes to join. And they said, you know, they said you have to kill a cop to be a Panther. I'll do it. They said you have to bring the gun back. I'll do it. I'm just fired up. You know how you're young and crazy? I'm 15 years old. And I just jump up and I said, choose me, brother. Arm me. Send me on a mission. I'm ready to kill Whitey right now. So I walk up to the front. He's sitting by a desk. I look at my, you know, the guys that I came with, like to say, yeah, boy, told you. This brother opens the desk. He reaches in, he pulls out. He's reaching real low. So now I look back at my boys. Man, he's going to give me a big gun. See how far down he's reaching in the desk? And he pulls out a stack of books. And I said, excuse me, brother. You said you were going to arm me. And he says, excuse me, young brother. I just did.
Now, why is it necessary for us to talk about the survival of our people? Many of us feel, many of our generation feel, that they're getting ready to commit genocide against us. Now, many people say that's a horrible thing to say about anybody. But if it is a horrible thing to say, then we should do as Brother Malcolm says, we should examine history. The birth of this nation was conceived in the genocide of the red man. Genocide of the red man. Of the red man. In order for this country to come about, the honky had to completely exterminate the red man, and he did it. And he did it. He did it. And he did it where he does not even feel sorry, but he romanticizes it by putting it on television with cowboy and Indians. Cowboy and Indians. If you do not think he's capable of committing genocide against us, check out what he's doing to our brothers in Vietnam. Check out what he's doing in Vietnam. Develop an undying love as is personified in Brother Huey P. Newton. If we do not do that, we will be wiped out. Our slogan will become, first our people, then and only then me and you as individuals. Our people first. Our people first. The concept of a black man is one who recognizes his cultural, his historical, and the roots of his great ancestors who were the greatest warriors on the face of this earth. African. African. African.
Millions of Americans live in food deserts where you can't find fresh produce. You can only find processed food. You can find ramen noodles and you can't find an apple. People do want to eat this food. They just don't have access to it.
There's more search for awareness with black people as to where we are and what has happened to us and what we're going to do with it.
You know, I dig the natural. I think the natural is a beautiful, beautiful way of wearing your hair for all black people.
When I get up in the morning, I'm natural.
I know what you
mean. And that's the way my hair is.
I'm so happy.
Kids is what make me feel so good.
See, you're looking at the glory that's coming up into the future of life. See, the younger youth is what's gonna make everything to keep going after I done passed down the hill.
Young, gifted,
and black. Pretty black.
You know, I be a Democrat every now and then. You know.
Wait,
no. I lose them. I be a Panther. But I'm always being black.
Hey, look, I'm not prejudiced because some of my best friends are colored, if you know what I'm talking about.
Black is beautiful because it feels so good.
If black is beautiful, white is divine.
Now that nigga's crazy.